Very dear students and audience, very warm welcome to my YouTube channel, Dr. Zia Ahmed. Today I'm going to talk about the nation building and the role of women writers with respect to the portrayal of women, which they have been doing in their novels. For this purpose, I have chosen the novel, The Heart Divided, Mumtaz Shahnawaz today. We need to take into consideration the idea given by Mohanty that the third world nations and their women, most of the time they think that the women are the people who are to live in houses and the best place for them is so, and they are counted most of the time as a non-progressive and their identity is known to be religious. But according to Mohanty, sometime they can be revolutionary as well, and this view is supported by another writer and critic, that is Sutherland. He says that that is right, that the domesticity or the place, domestic or the home, is the very place where women is known well in the third world, but sometime they can be revolutionary as well. This little bit of revolutionary in the women, that is the basis for making up the nation. Sutherland continues to say that men live in a nation, but these are the women who produce a nation. Definitely, these things are acceptable because history in many ways has proved that many revolutionary women made and paved the way. We are well aware of the efforts made by Virginia Woolf with respect to the writings of women and representation of women advocated by her. And today, we have large number of people who are women and they are writing very successful literature. Glaring examples of literature among the third world women are present in Pakistani fiction as well as in post-colonial fiction. So having got this basis, we need to talk about the character of Zohra, especially in the novel The Heart Divided. There are two or three more women available. One of them is Sughra, the sister of Zohra, Saraya, the friend of Zohra, and Mohini, another friend of Zohra. Mohini is Hindu. At that time, I do not have that much knowledge of the Hindu women and how they have been portrayed, but I will be talking about the Muslim women who are portrayed in this novel, The Heart Divided by Mumtaz Shahnawaz. Mumtaz Shahnawaz's portrayal of women is very progressive, is that revolutionary portrayal of women with the help of which nation building is possible, making of nation is possible. And at that time, when she was writing this novel in the 1940s, it is really revolutionary, not only to write, but also to portray such characters in the fiction. At the very same time, we have the mention of Ahmad Ali as well, whose novel Twilight in Delhi does portray the women, but they are not that progressive or that educated women as are the women portrayed by Mumtaz Shahnawaz. So seen in this context, Mumtaz Shahnawaz resembles more with Deepti Nazir Ahmed, who has been highlighted and has been told and discussed by Iqra Shagufta Chima in her essay Print Capitalism, Rise of the Muslim Indian National Consciousness and Muslim Women's Education in Colonial India. She gives the example of Miratul Arus, written by Deepti Nazir Ahmed. According to her, there are two characters, Akbari and Askari. Akbari is the elder one. She is, very stubborn sometime, and she is spoiled and she is irresponsible and disrespectful as well. And alongside that, we have Askari as well, who is a younger woman, but she is very much educated, very much qualified, and therefore she is capable of managing and doing her things at home. She can survive as well, she can earn as well. So in that way, these two women characters referred to by Iqra have paved the way in literature for the representation of those women who could be progressive. Mumtaz Shahnawaz's novel is a combination of these two, Akbari and Askari. It's more progressive. It's far, far away from the woman portrayal given by Ahmad Ali in his novel Twilight in Delhi. So seen in this context, we can see that Sughra is a very progressive character. Sughra is one of those characters who try to prove that domesticity may be an ideal and the service to society in which the women live, especially in the Muslim society, that may be an ideal, as was portrayed by Beheshti Zewar. But Miratul Aroos is the text which replaced Beheshti Zewar, because that represented old classical traditional way, and Miratul Aroos represented the modern progressive way. Thus, in the same tone, Mumtaz Shahnawaz portrays the character of Zohra. Zohra is a girl who is very much highly qualified and is a pampered child of her father. Her father, as shown in the text, he is foreign qualified, and he comes back and wants to see his women, wants to see his people also living and spending their life in the same progressive way, successive way, especially women, as he saw in England. But it was not possible for him because he lived in that society. But this possibility was brought by Zohra. Zohra not only was getting education, she was modern in her thinking as well. For example, she is the very first one who, by chance, or it may be by her effort as well, removed burqa when one day she was traveling with the driver and she forgot to take the upper part of her clothing on the head and went in the market with her friend Suraya in a tonga instead of going with the driver in the car. That raised a kind of storm at home. The storm was so severe that even her mother gave her a slap. And as a result, now this was the turn of Zohra to react and to prove what she wanted. So she resisted, she protested, and when her father came, she reported in the same way what has been done. But the father did not, you know, show that type of anger as the mother showed. So in that way, the foundation was there that Zohra will be the kind of girl who will take part in the public life, and she will not be restricting her life to domestic life only. So that is why Zohra, even when she was a college student, she started to take part in the protests arranged by the College Students Union. And she also protested against the police atrocities which were ordered by the English people. She also took part in the political gatherings and she gave speeches there. In that way, her role becomes 100% different from the role of the woman which were being played according to the novel of Ahmad Ali Twilight in Delhi. So in that way, we find in the whole social setup where women were not supposed to do these things, we find one woman who is laying the foundation of such women who will play a big role in the nation building. For example, later on in the struggle in the 1940s, we can see large number of Muslim women who were mostly foreign qualified. They took up the flag of Pakistan in their hand. They sat side by side with their men. They raised slogan, protested, demanded for the separate homeland. This was done later on. But it was Mumtaz Shahnawaz who, first of all, portrayed this type of character, which was the foundational character in the nation building of Pakistan. Though some of my friends will be saying that Zohra in the novel shows her strong support for the united liberation of India. It is right, because at that time, Pakistan's mention, plan of Pakistan, was not that openly and deliberately discussed by the political leaders as it was discussed the freedom of India. But as soon as the political leaders started to discuss the plan of establishing Pakistan and getting freedom from the British rulers, Zohra and her company, though disappointed up to some extent because they have been working for the freedom of India, United India, but they were also convinced that for the sake of Muslims, they need to live separate. They need to live in a country where these things can happen, which are according to their society. This debate of today's video is not political. It is about the work of the women. It is about the way women paved the way, laid the foundation of the struggle of women, because of which today we can see in Pakistan large number of women who are not only school going, but also college going, but also university going. They are getting high education, they are getting skilled education, professional education, and coming and contributing in the field, in print media, in digital media. Everywhere they are performing, though difficulties are there, of course. And this video I'm also recording in the sense that women should not be threatened, should not be murdered, should not be killed. Rather, they should be taught, they should be trained how to live in the society and how they can positively contribute into the well-being of the society. So, role of fiction in this way is established. role of the writers, how they show the future to the next coming generations, that is established, and Mohanty's point of view that it is the women who most of the time lay the foundation of nation building. Men definitely live the nation. Nation is because of them, but women are the revolutionary women who lay the foundation. So in this way, Mumtaz Shahnawaz's novel, The Heart Divided, is the type of novel where the women characters prefer their political, social, educational, and the life in which they can work for the society instead of the life which is totally restricting them to domesticity. Now, the debate is not that the domesticity should be 100% ignored. No, it has to go side by side. The Pakistani Muslim women would be happier if she is happy at home. So for the sake of her happiness, such arrangements are to be made, are required to be made, that they can get education, they can play a positive role in the society, and definitely such stories should be mentioned as the story mentioned by Mumtaz Shahnawaz in The Heart Divided, where this could be a model and a type of guideline and lesson for those women who want to continue with their life as a woman as well, and as a very much successful social being as well. Hopefully, we shall be discussing something more about this novel in some next coming video. So far, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully, you have liked it. If you like it, do not fail to hit the subscribe button as well. Thank you very much.